Hey, what is up everyone? Norman from Future Studio University here. Welcome to another video in our Retrofit series. After working on multiple topics regarding uploading files with Retrofit, in this video we will look at the opposite, downloading files with Retrofit. We will walk through three options on how to download files with Retrofit. As always, you can find the code and more explanations in written form on our website. It's the first link in the description below. First of all, Retrofit is a library for doing REST requests. Yes, it does support downloading files, which we will see in a second, but it's not the main purpose. If you're developing a download manager app without any API REST requests, you might want to look for another library. If downloading files is only one element of your app, Retrofit should serve you very well. Let's jump into it. I've prepared an app with the simple download file button. And the magic on what's happening when we click that button is still on our to-do lists. Let's get going. As always, when developing with Retrofit, we start by describing the endpoint. So let's go to the file download client. Now, usually this would be a REST endpoint where we describe the parameters and the return type. Now, you can also do the same for linking direct files. So let's just call this method download file. Now the return type needs to be the general response body class. As you know, we need to wrap it in a call object. Let me think, response body is right there. We will also need to add an annotation what kind of request it is. In this case, it's a GET request. The final thing is the location of the file. In this case, I will just copy and paste our logo into here. Let's remove these things. When executing this request, Retrofit will download this logo file. Now, it's important that you use the response body class. If you use a Java model, Retrofit might try to convert things with JSON or simple XML. And obviously, this won't work anymore. Since the file is binary data, we can just leave it in the general response body class. Okay. Now, as I said, we don't need any model classes, so the next step is our activity. Because we're downloading a file and then storing it on the user's disk, we need to make sure we have the permission to do so. So up here, I'm requesting the right external storage permission. Since this doesn't have much to do with this video, I already implemented all of that. Additionally, I've prepared the download button you have already seen. We have an onClick listener, and as soon as the button gets clicked, we will call this method. Now we will need to write this method. Here you can see using the Retrofit builder to build the Retrofit object. As you can see, we didn't add any converters or any interceptors because it's just not necessary here. We're just dealing with binary data. Now with this Retrofit object, we will create a download client. On the download client, we can call download file. And as always, on the call object, we can call NQ for the asynchronous execution. And once the server responded, we will get a callback. So if something didn't work out, we will just display a little toast. And if the server responded with a file, we will also display a toast for now. All right, let's see if this works. So I clicked on the button and we got a success message back, but where's the file? When we go back to this onResponse method, we will get the response from the server, but we're not doing anything with it. It would be just if you're getting a Java object, but you're not doing anything and just throwing it away. So what's missing here is to write the binary data as a file to the disk. I've already prepared a write response body to disk method, which creates a new file in the downloads directory. Obviously need to change it for your needs, but for now this is good enough. And then it's just the regular Java IO boilerplate code. So we will take some streams and we write it from the network file to the local file on disk. And at the end, if everything worked out, we return true. So let's pass the response body, so the binary data, to that method. And we can access the binary data by calling body on the response object. Now we can also check if this worked out, since we're getting a Boolean back. And let's change the toast message. And let's try this again. Now before I click download, let's jump into our download file or download directory. And as you can see, there's nothing here right now. So go back to the activity, click download. And apparently, yes, it worked out. So if we go back to our, and here's our logo, just like we wanted to. You can also open it. And there it is, beautiful. However, this only works if you already know in advance what file you want to download. If it's a little dynamic, like you're getting the file URL from your API response, this won't work. So in the next part, we will utilize the dynamic URL feature to download any file we want without already knowing where the file is going to be. So we will utilize this string, which will represent any dynamic string you can imagine. Of course, we will also need to adjust the API description. So let's copy and paste this and add the URL parameter. Now, if you don't know what I'm doing here, we did a whole video on the URL parameter. I will link that also in the description below, so feel free to check that out if you haven't seen this before. Now we need to change our method, so let's pass the URL here. And down here, we need to pass it as well. Now everything else can stay the same since we are just getting a different file now. And let's try this out and fix this typo. Now before we download the file, let's delete this one. And click download. Okay, that was fast. Now the preview, for some odd reason, is still the same, but if you click into it, you can see it's a different logo. Okay, that worked out well. So as you can see, it's pretty easy to download any file, even if you don't know the URL in advance. Okay, everything works, right? Why is the video only half over? Now this approach has one large flaw. Retrofit, by default, keeps the response in memory. So basically, when the server responds with some data, Retrofit will keep the connection open, wait until everything is there, and then pass it over to JSON or SIP/XML for conversion. When the server responds with binary data, the file can be pretty large. So if you're downloading a 50 megabyte file, Retrofit will try to keep those 50 megabytes in memory. If the file gets pretty large, a lot of devices will start crashing because they don't have that much memory available. Now, Retrofit's solution here is to stream the response to the app. Whenever the server responds with the first bytes, it will hand over the result right away. It won't wait until the entire response is there. the app then has to deal with the incoming stream of bytes and write it to the disk. So let's do that. Once again, we have to change our description here, and we will keep using the dynamic URL just because it's so helpful. All we have to change here is to add a streaming annotation. And let's change the name so Java won't annoy us. And what this means, if we execute this method, Retrofit will return the callback right away, and we have to just listen to that open stream of bytes and write it down. So once again, we have to make some changes here. And now we're using the streaming way of doing it. So we get the response here and write it down to the file. Let's try this out. Okay, the app crashed. What happened here? Let's jump into the Android monitor. And as you can see here, Android throws the network on main exception, which is weird because we called the asynchronous NQ method. So what's happening is that thread goes onto a background thread to execute the request. And when the request comes back, it will call the UI thread in this onResponse method. Now we pass along the server response stream, which is in this response, and try to write it to the disk. So we have a network stream of data coming in, and we're trying to write it to disk on the UI thread. So this is why we're getting a network on main exception, even though we not originally started the request on the main thread. So the solution here is to write the response body not on the UI thread, instead on a background thread too. Now the quickest way of creating a background thread is just to wrap it into an async task. Now let's get rid of our toast, and we need to make this final. And when the background thread of Retrofit comes back with the response, with the first bytes of the response, we will immediately pass it along to another background thread, which will take care of the incoming data and write it to disk. So this hopefully works. And what did I forget? Oh, I forgot a return type. All right, here we go, our last attempt. I'm convinced this will work, so let's delete this file one more time. Jump into our app, start the download, and now when we are writing the file to the disk, we're actually doing it on another background thread, so everything should work out. And if we jump to our Explorer, yes, the file's actually there, and if we're opening that file, you can still see our nice logo there. Excellent. So let's review what we have learned in this video. We have seen three ways of downloading files with Retrofit. The first way is just like a basic API REST request. We simply request the resource and then write the bytes to the disk. Now the second way extended on that and used the dynamic URL feature to request any file we wanted and not just on our own domain. And the last bit was dealing with large files. If the file gets very large, we can use a streaming annotation to pass along the response as soon as the first bytes come in. This has the advantage that it doesn't matter how large the file is, Retrofit will handle it. There are two more things I want to show you in a future video. One is how to download files in the background thread. If you don't want to deal with all the UI back and forth and async task, you can do it in a background service. It makes it a little nicer. Additionally, I want to show you a progress. So if you're downloading 100 megabytes of file, which it will take a minute, you want to inform the user about the status. Both of that will come in a future video, but until then, I will link a guide for that in the description below. Thanks for watching, like the video if you've learned something, and subscribe if you want to see more videos in this series. Enjoy coding and make it rock!